Well, yet another bitter disappointment. So, I went out and I got the Infernal Crypts by Dungeon Saga. And much to my dismay, I open up the box completely excited, okay? I know my history of Mantic. I know that I've always ran into different kind of problems, but for the third time out of five boxes, I'm missing two heroes. The two heroes that were supposed to come in the game didn't come in the game. Now, everything else came in, and everything else looks great. I mean, I really like what they're doing here. So, again, this almost becomes like another high and low video with these guys, because the highs are, hey, that guy's pretty cool looking, and it's good plastic, and the big guy, he's standing upright, so I got no problem with that. Are the little guys flimsy? Yeah, look at that plastic. Ugh. It could snap at any time. And you got plenty more spell cards and more dungeon stuff and the bookcase thing, which is really cool. I like how all my bookcases are starting to come together, and I'm starting to try to figure out, ooh, boy, this is going to be looking really good on the shelf, and I could pull this out anytime I want to go at it. But once again, I was going to buy so much for that Kings of War, and I held back because I just knew this would be a disaster if I did. And I really want to. I wanted to do more of the Dreadball, not Dreadball, oh God, Dead Zone? Yeah, because I got it over here somewhere. The Dead Zone thing. I wanted to get some more of the different factions and stuff like that. I wanted to support the Walking Dead, thinking maybe, things will be a different. And, another disappointment. But I can't let that deter from what the game and what I'm going to rate the game. And you can check that on the Dice Tower next week as I'll be talking about this. But I wanted to bring this up to you guys and let you know what I kind of thought and how disappointing it was to get yet another game missing parts. And it's not really their fault. When if you look at some of the comments when we talked to the actual owner of Mantic. Well, last time I went on a rant with them, well, it wasn't too bad, but I told them my ups and downs of Mantic. He was very kind to say exactly what goes on. He can't control that, unfortunately. Even though he's responsible for it in the long run, the quality control is done by somebody else, and he cannot sit there and hold somebody's hand and run an entire company. So, in some ways, I do forgive them, but boy, I tell you, if I was him, I'd run down there and give them a good swift kick in their butt and say, hey, we've got a great game here. We've got good fans, good loyal fans. I'm still buying it. I want to be a huge fan of Mantic. I want to get Kings of War. I want to, I'd rather play that than Warhammer 40K. I mean, Fantasy right now. I like to see what this Kings of War is like, but why would I go get it when all I do is 3 out of 5 I have problems with? Well, leave your comments below. Let me know what you think, guys. Till next time, it's your pal Rob. I'll catch you later.